I'm looking for a very special old book.
A book? Listen, lady, this is a gas station. We don't sell no books.
Actually, for you, lady, we just started selling them.
Originally released in all of its low-res, pixelated glory back in 2010, the point-and-click puzzler The Journey Down has had somewhat of a makeover.
I quite like the look of the original Hex. It harkens back to those old LucasArts days and suited the game well.
Plus it was and still is free.
However, if you're keen to experience the game with a look and feel that's a little more current, the first two chapters of a new HD version have been recently released online for a pretty reasonable price, with a few additional locations and puzzles thrown in as well.
Well, the first thing I noticed about this game was the incredibly unique character art. Great. Most of the characters in The Journey Down have been modelled from African masks, which gives an unusual quality to it, especially since no one has any eyeballs.
Amazing!
The whole world is an interesting mishmash of ideas though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's kind of film noir goes Caribbean. The game begins with brothers Buana and Quito discovering that the power has been cut to the gas station they own due to unpaid bills.
Man, we're screwed now.
Oh man.
As luck would have it, a young woman by the name of Lena offers to pay them in return for helping her get to the mysterious town of Port Artu, where she's hoping to track down a lost artifact.
There's some fun humour to the character writing and dialogue, with the game's protagonist Buana being instantly likeable as he chatters away.
It's a patron of our father, Captain Conan Dodo. He adopted me and Quito off the streets when we were scumbag kids.
Sometimes he takes too long to get to the point though, Hex.
Yeah, there are some seriously long conversations in this game in general. They're skippable, but the information in those exchanges is generally pretty important. So I wouldn't advise it.
Ever heard of someone named Conan Dodo?
Conan Dodo? Haven't heard that name in a long, long time. A pilot, isn't he?
Yeah, that's him!
Yes, there were some massively long conversations that I just skipped over, only to have to go back and listen to them all again later.
I was concerned about the puzzles to begin with.
This might be dumb enough to work.
One of the early ones required me to replace the rungs of a ladder with breadsticks.
Man, they fit perfectly!
I mean, I dismissed that idea initially because I was like, as if breadsticks would hold human weight, but that was the solution, it turns out.
Let's hope they don't snap when we climb them. After you, lady.
Well, they were stale breadsticks.
Right, well, I guess the laws of physics just led me astray. Once I got into that quirky headspace, though, I found some wonderful challenge in solving these puzzles.
This had to spice things up.
Yeah, this isn't the place for regular logic. It's video game logic only here. And I had just the right amount of challenge that I want from a point-and-click adventure like this.
Yeah, you'll definitely need a lot of patience and lateral thinking. And some of it is about going through all of the items in your inventory and trying to combine them or see how they might be used.
I'm not so sure Makina would approve of my cooking, but okay.
One gripe I have is having to keep going back and talking to people to get more information from them in order to progress to the next stage of the puzzle.
Well, that settles it. We'll raise anchor tonight.
Once I've spoken to someone, I figure the job is done, and then I spend the rest of the time just looking for objects and items.
I did enjoy episode 2 way more than episode 1, though. The locations and characters were so much more interesting and there was more to do, though I did find myself going back and forth a lot as well, which got a bit tedious. Still, humour was woven into even the puzzle scenarios, which I loved.
Yeah, they were unique problems, weren't they? How do I get past this vicious pelican, for example?
Ah! No way, I'm going closer, man.
Or this hungry man who keeps eating all my canapes.
Oh man, you finished all my canapes!
This new version brings with it a great voice cast, which was something that was lacking from the original game.
Oh, you don't want to mess with a man. He's a mean dude with a license to grind your bones to dust if he wants to.
Yeah, I agree. Another thing I want to mention is the extra content unlocked at the end of episode 1. Developer diaries, photos, concept art.
There were even screenshots of random code, weren't there?
Yeah, I loved that. It was wonderful to actually get an insight into the whole process, especially since this was essentially from a one-man team in terms of game design. Overall, I think this was a really lovely experience. The HD makeover has definitely refreshed this story. There's an interesting uniqueness to the world it's set in, and the puzzles offered a decent level of challenge.
Man, this lamp is smashed beyond repair. I gotta find a replacement.
I don't think I could actually recommend the re-release though, Hex.
Really?
Yeah, well, not over the original. The HD release felt a bit like it was from the mid-90s rather than something truly current.
I completely disagree. I think this version had way more life and spark to it. I'm giving it 7.
Yeah, well, this is still a good game. I just prefer the original, so I'm giving it 6.
Oh, no!
That was Bomba!